A clipping mask clips a layer to the visible parts of the layer beneath it. You can see a clipping mask in action right now. It's a great way to restrict layers to a particular shape, just as the clipping mask on the ocean photo you are seeing now restricts it to appear only within the underlying text layer. You can even have a stack of layers with clipping masks, all clipped by the same underlying layer or base layer. In this video, you'll learn how you can use clipping masks in your own projects. Using clipping masks is easy. We'll show you how to do it with just a circle and a square, where the circle is in front of and overlapping the square. To create a clipping mask, tap the circle to select it, then head to this menu, and finally tap on Create Clipping Mask. On iPad and on Mac, simply select the layer and then choose Create Clipping Mask. You may have noticed that a downward pointing arrow has appeared next to the circle layer's thumbnail. This tells us that the circle is being clipped by the square. We can confirm this by looking at the composition area. Only the portion of the circle that was overlapping the square is now visible. If you decide you no longer want the mask, you can remove it easily by tapping the circle layer to select it, then head to this menu, and then Release Clipping Mask. On iPad and on Mac, simply select the layer and then choose Release Clipping Mask. We can now see the entire circle again. You can clip multiple layers to the same base layer, as long as they're in a stack together directly above it. Let's add a star shape to our project and create a clipping mask. The star is clipped by the circle layer. If you also add a clipping mask to the circle, the square becomes the base layer for the clipping masks on both the circle and star layers. In this particular project, to remove the clipping mask from all layers, select the circle layer, then head to this menu and tap Release Clipping Mask. This works because removing the clipping mask from a layer also removes the clipping mask from any other layers with clipping masks stacked directly above it. On iPad, select the circle layer, then choose Release Clipping Mask. Clipping masks are a great way to control the appearance of layers on screen. But did you know they can work with layer parenting in interesting ways? This example uses both layer parenting and a clipping mask to make only the shadow of the plane visible as it travels through the clouds. Let's see how it works. Let's just start with the aeroplane and the cloud layer. We haven't adjusted the Z or Z coordinate of any of the layers. So, when you press play, the plane disappears completely under the cloud. If we duplicate the aeroplane and drag it above the cloud, we see it fly above the cloud. Both layers operate just as we'd expect. Let's turn this duplicated aeroplane layer into a shadow. First, rename the layer to Shadow. Then, add the solid color effect and change the color to match the example. Since we only want the shadow to appear within the cloud, let's apply a clipping mask to it. When we press play, we see the shadow appears only when the plane is in the cloud. Here's where things get interesting. If you make the original aeroplane layer the parent of the shadow, and then scale down the aeroplane over time, you can make the plane look like it's diving under the cloud. Because the shadow is the child of the aeroplane, it moves with the aeroplane. But because it is clipped by the visible parts of the cloud layer, we only see it when the plane passes through the cloud. The combination of these two features allows for a seamless transition between aeroplane layers as the cloud passes by, making the shadow effect believable. Did you enjoy learning how to use clipping masks in your projects? We can't wait to see your creations. Make sure to show us anything you make by posting your creations with the hashtag #AMClippingMasks. If you have any questions, please ask them in the comments, and make sure to follow us for more videos on Alight Motion.